Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about some frequently asked questions on how to spray foam your pole barn. So we're going to talk about closed cell versus open cell. We're going to talk about how the cost is calculated. We're going to talk about the overhead door. Can you do it? How should you do it? And also we're going to talk about how to handle ventilation. So first things first, closed cell versus open cell. Age old debate. We're not going to settle it here. Rule of thumb, if you're doing a pole barn, closed cell is probably the way to go. Couple reasons. One, on the walls, a lot of times pole barn insulation will be left exposed. Closed cell insulation is very durable, it's very dense and rigid and tough. That durability can really help out. So if you're anything like us, you may bump into the walls from time to time, sometimes with vehicles or different things like that. You may want to hang tools on your walls or shelves or anything like that. That closed cell, that rigidity really goes a long way for that. If you have open cell on the walls, especially if it's exposed, it can get torn up pretty quickly. So again, a pole barn, especially if it's going to be used for any type of work environment, that durability, that ruggedness with closed cell will really come into play. For the ceiling, the roof doesn't make too much of a difference as far as open cell or closed cell for application benefits. Efficiency, you're in the same boat either way, but for the walls, closed cell, I generally recommend. Cost. Most of the time, the cost is always going to be figured out based on the square footage. That's the square footage of the treated area. So that's the actual surface square footage of the walls or the ceiling. Not the what we would consider the living space of a barn or like a house or something like that. So again, the square footage of the treated area is generally how cost will be figured out. Overhead doors. Simple answer, they can be done pretty easily. Closed cell foam is usually the way to go. However, there are some question marks. Open cell can be used quite often as well. The biggest concern for an overhead door on a pole barn is going to be weight. Obviously, closed cell is a lot heavier than open cell. So if you spray that door and you could have issues with the door mechanism opening and closing, your door may not be able to lift as much and that could cause issues, could cause damage down the road to your mechanism. So again, keep in mind the added weight could cause issues. If that's the case, open cell is usually not a problem. With open cell, there are a couple more steps involved with the overhead door because you will have to cut the doors at where the panels bend and come together as the door starts to come up. So you're gonna have to cut all those angles. So it takes a little bit longer to do, but open cell can be done. And obviously it comes out a little bit thicker, so you have to work with it a little bit more, but the weight really is gonna determine that answer. Last thing, ventilation. Simplest thing, close up all your free air vents, just like we talk about in a roof and an attic and in a house. You want to close up all your free air vents, use mechanical vents. Usually one intake and one exhaust on either end of your building will be enough. That's what we have in our barn. We have an intake and we have an exhaust set up. It's just on the wall, it's a 2x2 vent, and that is more than enough for our space. Now again, the size of your barn, what you're doing in that barn, relative humidity levels, all that will come into play to see what size vent that you may need. Also, you know, if you need to add more or if you have different rooms or additions to your barn, things like that. But the base answer is mechanical ventilation is the way to go. Get rid of all the free air vents. If you have gable vents, I always recommend to seal those up. Stick to your mechanicals. So obviously there's a lot more information on pole barns and spray foaming them. These are just some of the big questions that we get a lot. You should definitely check out our website, RetroFoamofMichigan.com. Check out our blog where we have much more information on some of these topics. Be sure to like this video. Leave us a comment. If you have a question about your pole barn that I didn't go over or maybe on the website or something like that, ask us about it. We'd love to help you out. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and smash that bell so you see all of our notifications. Wow. Hey, if you guys are really into foam, should check out some of our guides. We have some for existing homes, new homes, and pole barns. It's really hot.